Hello everyone! In this tutorial we will look at cues, how to create them and what kind of settings and options there are. In general, the upper empty part above here is always reserved for cues. By double-clicking in that area, you can simply create a cue. I'm going to create a play cue, which is also the default. On the right side, you can see the inspector which shows the different cue settings. First in line is time. You can change the values by clicking and dragging the mouse button, or you can just add a new value manually. As with other values, the last two digits refer to the frame rate, preceded by seconds, minutes, and hours. So entering 350 would translate into 3 seconds and 50 frames. The next field shows you the cue number, which gets allocated automatically in ascending order. Label allows you to label your cues. Let's label this one Wait Cue. Operation refers to what the cue actually does. The first one we'll be looking at is the play cue. What makes the play cue special is the wait duration. If we enter 4 seconds here, it means that the playout will stop at the cue for 4 seconds. Once the locator hits the cue, you can see that it waits 4 seconds before the playout continues. This option is unique to the play cue. Let's now create a second cue so that we can look at additional options like pause, which is a simple pause. We're getting to the cue and hit pause. And then the wait continues until another play action gets executed, which you could do via the timeline on the left. And the timeline continues playing. There's also the option of right-clicking on an actual clip to add a pause cue right before the clip is supposed to start. Let's continue by looking at another type of cue, the stop cue, which is a simple stop command. This will stop the timeline and will move the locator back to the beginning. The last type of cue we will look at is a jump cue. With the jump cue, you can define whether you want to jump to a particular time. Let's enter 2 seconds or 200 to demonstrate this. And as you can see, we have an active jump cue. Or you could choose to label and then define it as the wait cue. This new cue would then jump to the wait cue. The last field we should look at is activity, which you can set to active, which makes it active. Ignore, which would mean the cue would be ignored completely, or ignore once, which would mean that the cue would get ignored only once. Just in case you're wondering about trigger timeline, this is something we will look at in another tutorial when we're dealing with multiple timelines one could trigger. Blend duration allows us to activate a blending at the beginning of a clip when a cue is being executed. We go to our jump cue, and as you can see, the locator turns blue and we generate a blend or fade during the actual jump. Let's look at it one more time. Jump, and the blending happens. Last, but definitely not least in this tutorial, we have API commands. This allows you to send out commands via the PIXERA API. So we could, for example, implement some JavaScript here if we wanted to. Thank you for watching this PIXERA tutorial. Why not subscribe to our YouTube channel?